Welcome to this episode of Star Wars Declassified, where we look into different facts and stories revolving around the Star Wars canon universe and lore. In today's Declassified, we'll be taking a look at all the different types of milk in the Star Wars universe, especially blue and green milk, two of the better well-known milk beverages in the galaxy far, far away. Blue milk, a food staple within the Star Wars franchise which first appeared in Episode 4, A New Hope. Since then, it's been frequently seen in other movies, shows, comics, and even novels. So, what exactly is blue milk? Where does it come from and why is it blue? Well, blue milk is technically known as Bantha milk, along with it having the nickname Tatooine milk as well. As the name suggests, it is a blue-colored milk produced by female banthas native to Tatooine. And while of course blue milk itself could be found on most planets across the galaxy, it is still nonetheless the primary export of Tatooine. In addition, it was also a popular product in the bar and diner scene, having even been sold at Dex's Diner on Coruscant. Blue milk as a drink was well known for being very rich and refreshing, with its opaque coloring suggesting that it was also very sweet. As for the blue coloring, that itself was the result of the liquid being produced by a female bantha's mammary glands. The milk was also used to make a variety of yogurt, ice cream, cheese, and a dessert called blue milk custard, a favorite of Jedi Knight Kanan Jarrus. Interestingly enough, its ubiquity also inspired the military phrase Blue Milk Run, which was especially heard within the Rebel Alliance Navy. Green milk, while not as popular, was seen as the next best alternative option to blue milk. However, rather than come from banthas, it was produced by female Talasirans, whom were found on the planet Octo and among many other watery worlds. It was only really during the war between the First Order and the Resistance that Talasiran green milk gained more widespread popularity, as it was then exported to Bubbo Wamba family farms on the planet Batuu, who in turn sold it across Black Spire Outpost. Mura milk was another milk only found in a few planets. It came from the Mura, who were strong herbivorous herd animals with a thick, bristly hide and tusks. While mainly bred for their meat and thick hides, their milk was also edible and drank primarily on planets that had bred them. Nutritive milk was another type of milk often seen drank by those in a military setting. While not the tastiest, it was definitely a very healthy and filling option, allowing anyone who drank it to no longer be hungry for an entire day. It was actually for these reasons alone that it became the primary alternative to food for Saw's partisans. Nerf milk was a type of chalky tasting milk produced by Nerfs, who were furry non-sentient animals raised for not just their milk, but as well their meat and hide. While the Nerf milk was not known for its taste, it did contain nutritional benefits, and was often used to make different types of cheeses. Of course, while there were different types of milk seen throughout the galaxy, none of which could ever overtake blue milk in either popularity or availability. And that'll do it for this episode. If you enjoyed what you saw, please like and share it, along with subscribing to the channel to not only support it, but keep up with Star Wars news, gaming, and canon lore released every week. And consider following me on Twitter and Facebook to never miss out on the latest Star Wars related content. And if you want to further support the channel, then check out our Patreon page to become a Knight of Silo, or click the YouTube join button to join the Silo fleet. Or if you want to continue the conversation, then join us on the official Silo Discord server. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.